Hey guys, how's it going? That's right here. Gonna do a little bit of Uber laddering. Just, you know, unwind, have some fun. got a cool team. I like to call it Temporal Heat. I'm not really sure what the point of this team was. I just kind of wanted to build around Dialga and Groudon a little bit without going full semi room like normally do. So I decided to try to scarf Dialga out a little bit. I've got, you know, standard Primal Groudon. I can't quite remember what the speed creep. Oh, it's a Breloom creep. So, I mean, I think this is a VGC set. This is a VGC 16 set for Ho-Oh Bulky Citrus Berry. Protect, Tailwind, Secret Fire, Brave Bird. It's a pretty good set here. We've got standard Mega Kangaskhan, Fake Out, Sucker Punch, Low Kick, Frustration. Nice and easy. We got Life Orb Yveltal. Fun fact, this Yveltal actually hits as hard as Life Orb Bisharp, even with the negative attack nature. The power of Dark Aura. And lastly, we've got probably my favorite Pokemon to use in Uber. Well, doubles Uber at least, which is Ghost Arceus, because plus two Shadow Forge is just broken. I'm sorry, it's broken. So anyway, let's see what we can get for battles. This is back. Why are you back? I guess we got a little cup tournament. I might do some little cup later. If this thing will cooperate with me, that'd be great. Yeah, you can tell how tired I am. Might take us a minute to get a battle, so I mean, I guess we can go ahead and talk about Sun and Moon a little bit. Let's take a look at these new Pokemon, why don't we? I mean, yeah, Groudon's got base 150 special attack in primal form. So we've got Dartrix, we've got Torracat, and we've got annoying notifications popping up and disrupting my video. Brionne. Now, easily, Torracat's my favorite of these two, because, I mean, honestly, Litten looks awesome in this form. And Dartrix, I mean, this thing just looks like your standard emo freaking high schooler. And Brionne, I'm not really sure what to make of this. I mean, the leaked evolution looks awesome. I mean, I'll tell you that much. Which I won't show until a little later, but, I don't know, this design doesn't really, I don't really feel this design too much, honestly. But, I like Popplio overall, but I mean, it's definitely weaker than these other two, I'll say that. But I mean, not a bad design by any means. Do we have a battle yet? No? Still, guess no one's on this ladder. Another cool thing we got was Ash Greninja, and we're gonna be able to play with this guy in the demo, which is gonna be coming out on the 14th. Which is around the time Korokoro leaks, so we'll get Korokoro and then we'll immediately get the demo, so that'll be pretty cool. So, I mean, same Water Dark, 411, 88 pounds, really light Pokemon, Ninja Pokemon. It's got its new ability Battle Bomb, which will turn it into Ash Greninja when you knock out a Pokemon, so. Is this better than Protean, or are we still going to stick with Protean Greninja? I mean, even still, Greninja's still probably going to get banned in Sun and Moon by Smokon. At the least, because, I mean, even if this form is weaker than Protean Greninja, I mean, Protean Greninja is still just as stupid, and I mean, we have seen this thing compete with, like, Zardex and stuff, so I mean, and you have to remember, this thing doesn't lose a battle item, so I mean, this thing could essentially, once it transforms, have, you know, mega Pokemon level stats with the freaking item, similar to Mega Rayquaza. So, I mean, and it's not that hard to, you know, be playing through the game, weaken something, and, you know, just get a quick RK with Greninja, which is one of its best jobs, and then all of a sudden, boom, Ash Greninja. And, you know, guess what? You still have your Mega Pokemon in the back. So, I mean, it might not be, like, as immediately powerful, or just as immediately just dick-breaking as Protean Greninja, but I can definitely see Ash Greninja being a freaking problem. I mean, if not, then, you know, I can be wrong, just like I am wrong with these battles coming in quickly, but I mean, Other than that, I'm excited to use Ash Greninja. I mean, they could have honestly called this thing anything other than Ash Greninja. Because, I mean, where the hell is Ash? But, I mean, oh well. And I was also hoping and praying that they would actually let other Pokemon, you know, take these synchronized, you know, bond, you know, maximum friendship bond, whatever the hell forms. But apparently, Greninja's the only one that can go Super Saiyan 4 in this game, so, oh well. Guess we get what we get, but, I mean, I'm happy we got it anyway, because, I mean, this Greninja was pretty badass. I mean, had plot armor like a bitch, but, I mean, it was still pretty badass. And, I mean, there weren't any other Pokemon really revealed to us here. I mean, we just have the starter evolutions, which are beautiful, by the way. Except, you know, you're kind of meh, in my opinion. I'm pretty sure people are going to tear me apart for that. But, yeah. I want you to evolve. I want you to evolve very badly. I want you to be good, damn it. I'm tired of Azumarill. I'm tired of getting pursuit trapped. I'm just tired of priority, period. Please be good. I want to see this thing revealed officially. Like, I think they fucked up revealing it in the, keeping it in the trailer. And, you, I have very high hopes for you. I like this thing so much. Like, it's easily one of my favorite Gen 7 Pokemon. Not much else here. I mean, I want these two to be good very badly. We got a battle. Who we got? We've got Mewtwo, Ho-Oh, Liepard, Xerneas, Primal Kyogre, and Lugia. Alright. I'm not really sure how he's going to lead here. He's probably going to lead Liepard, Xerneas. So, I'm going to go ahead and lead Peadon and my Mega Kangaskhan, which does have the inner focus. Okay, so he leads Mewtwo and Primal Kyogre. So I can easily just go ahead and get a Precipice off on these guys while I go ahead and hit this Kyogre with a Fake Out. Try to get some good damage off on it. Excuse me, holy crap. I'm so sorry. Okay, so it's Mega Mewtwo Y. No Protect, so you're going to get rocked by these Precipice Blades. Hurricane. Okay, I see what you're doing now. And I'm faster than it. Oh, because I obviously saw it was faster than it. So I'm going to go ahead and hit Earth Power and hit Sucker Punch here. Okay, you're gone. I'm going to pray this isn't a speed tie. Ah, nice. Alright, so that's one huge threat down. So I'm hoping he sends out the Xerneas now. Okay, no, he sends out his double birds. So I can't actually do anything to either of these. So, well, I mean, I can hit this, but I'm going to go ahead and switch to my own Ho-Oh, and go ahead and get a... Actually, I'm going to go ahead and switch to my own Ho-Oh, and my Dialga, I guess. It doesn't really do anything for me at this point. And hopefully he doesn't... Okay, so Lugia uses Tailwind and he uses Earthquake, that's fine. I'm going to go ahead and use my own Tailwind, and if he wants to go ahead and Earthquake me, that again, that's fine. I'm going to go ahead and go for my Draco on this Ho-Oh. Okay, he's going to Aeroblast me, that's fine. You're going to go for another Earthquake, that's fine. Go ahead and just drop a Draco on you. That did absolutely nothing. Wow. Okay. So I'm going to go ahead and Brave Bird this and just go ahead and drop another Draco on this Lugia just to go ahead and break its multi-scale. Okay, so Specs Dialga really isn't that strong. He's going to knock me out. That's fine. I'm unfortunately not able to knock it out. And he knocks me out with his own Life Orb Brave Bird. That's fine. So I'm going to go ahead and send in my Mega Kangaskhan. My Mega Kangaskhan and my Arceus. Not Arceus. My Yveltal. And he sends out his Liepard. That's fine. He's probably going to fake me out here. That's fine if he does. I'm going to go ahead and hit a Dark Pulse on this Lugia. It's okay. He fakes out my Kangaskhan. That's fine. I'm not sure what the Lugia just did to me. Okay, he Aeroblasted me. That's fine. I know you're sad, so I'm going to just go ahead and hit you with a quick frustration while I try to go ahead and slurp up this Lugia real quick. And, you know, this guy can go ahead and take around. I'm clicking timer, dude. Come on. So anyway, he's going to die here. Okay, he's going to protect. Why do you protect now? Ooh, that hurt way too much. You weren't even sashed, my friend. Come on. What's up, William? How you doing? Haven't seen you around. I love new faces. Okay, so now he's got no choice but to send in Xerneas, which I'm obviously going to double into. Actually, no, I'm not going to double into it. I am going to just go ahead and hit it with a frustration, and I'm going to go ahead and hit this Lugia up. Because he could easily protect his Xerneas and set up Tailwind again, and then I'm going to be in a very bad spot. So I'm going to go ahead and hit frustration on this. And I'm going to go ahead and hit him with another Dark Pulse. And I should be faster than this unless this thing is timid. Which, if he's running timid Xerneas, then I don't know what's wrong with him. But you don't need all that speed in this tier, friend. But I mean, if he's not, then I should be able to get at least 70% damage off on him, which would be great. And go ahead and knock out this Lugia. If he protects, that's fine. Because then I'll just be able to double on him next turn. I mean, this Lugia's dying either way, so. Let's see what she does. Okay, so she doesn't protect, and I get about 60%, so that's fine damage. And he's going to go ahead and use the Geomancy. I should be able to knock this out with two Sucker Punches. And if not, I do have Groudon in the back still. So, I mean, obviously the Xerneas is not going to sweep me, so I'm going to just go ahead and drop it. GG, my friend. Go ahead and, oh my lord, I can't believe you actually lived both of those. Alright, that's unexpected, but I do have the E-Speed, and I do have my mixtape. So, you can go ahead and fold over. Come on, friend, just go ahead and give me the points. there we go. GG, friend. You put up a good fight. I'll go ahead and save that battle. Why not? I can retrieve that later. Alright, let's go ahead and start looking for another one. And while we do that, what was I talking about again? Alright, we were going to look at Askreninja. We were looking at Askreninja. So yeah, again, I'm hyped for this. You know, basically says, you know, this is the form Greninja takes when he's with Ash, blah blah blah. Known as the Bond Phenomenon, which they do not expand on whatsoever. Why not? Honestly, why not? You just have that open door right there. Walk into it, Game Freak, please. But honestly, like, they could have done so much with the starters. I mean, obviously this shouldn't double on Mega Evolution, because otherwise, you know, Zardex would just be the Lord and Savior here. But, and, you know, Blaziken would just be the Antichrist of everything. But other than that, it says, Ash Greninja's leg strength has been enhanced compared to the Inordinator Greninja, making it difficult to see because of the speed at which it can move. It takes its enemies out in a flash. It becomes able to make a giant water shuriken on its back and can throw them in rapid succession. So, obviously this thing's gonna be, like, lightning fast. And probably much stronger than the ordinary Greninja. And I'm pretty sure we're going to get that, you know, giant, you know, Super Saiyan Fuma Shuriken as a form of a Z-move. So, if anything, Ash Greninja's probably going to get its own Z-move. It might even take the form of Ash Greninja if you're just regular Greninja, who knows. Like, if it's a Z-move, that'll only happen if you're actually Ash Greninja at the time. That'll be a little weird, and I'm not entirely sure how they would play that one. But, I mean, they've done stranger things before, honestly. Oh yeah, type null. I want you to do something cool. Take off that helmet, Brain. Just take off that freaking helmet. Take off that helmet, show us how epic you are. Tapu Koko, you're going to Ubers. Solgaleo, please get fire coverage and not just be another Metagross. Lunala, you're bad. Come down to OU so I can have some fun with you. Magearna, yeah, you're getting banned. You're just so stupid. Like, this thing's gonna be broken, I just know it. And same with being broken is we don't have any battles yet. Because why not? The only other thing I really wanted to talk about was Global Link. Because Global Link's getting a massive overhaul, friends. Like, Global Link's going out there. Like, I'll read you a little bit of it, because, you know, why not? Pokemon Global Link, the website, and then blah blah, okay, we don't need to know that. And, you know, you guys have to call me right now. Shut up. You guys have to call me right now. Shut up. Sorry about that. So, it's going to be updated for Sun and Moon on Friday, November 18th, in sync with the launch of Pokemon Sun and Moon. And it'll also be in sync with us getting a battle. And this man's got Lugia, Darkrai, Mega Mewtwo, Greninja, Jirachi, and Xerneas. So I'm assuming he's probably going to try some Matlock shenanigans with his Xerneas. Some Follow Me shenanigans with that Jirachi. So I think Kangaskhan Groudon's going to be a pretty good lead here. Yeah, I think that'll be our best lead here. We can probably catch this crowd, Darkrai. Unless we can go ahead and lead Ghost Arceus. I'm actually going to try to lead Ghost Arceus this time. What do we have? Xerneas, Jirachi. We can fake this out. Swords Dance up. Go ahead and fake that out. Get a dance up. And if you just follow me, that's fine. I'm going to just go ahead and switch to my Groudon and click Shadow Force on this Xerneas. Because at this point, everything literally just gets one-shotted. He gets his Geomancy up, that's fine. I'm going to go ahead and hit Precipice Blades, and we're going to go ahead and continue with the Shadow Force. I'm not sure if this redirects after I go into the Shadow Force or not. If it does, this Jirachi dies. This takes a wallop. And, ooh, that Moonblast hurt. Okay, so I do get redirected still. And now you're in E-Speed range, so goodbye. What he can do here is send out the Darkrai, which will be problematic, but that's okay. I'm going to hit him up with that mixtape real quick and go ahead and hit you with that E-Speed. I shouldn't die from this. I should be able to take this unless it's like Choice Specs or something. Yeah, I knew I could be. I should have been able to take that. And you just die. You just freaking die. Alright. I'll take that. So my only real problem right now is this Mewtwo. So I'm going to go ahead and let my Groudon take the hit while I go ahead and protect my Arceus. Yeah, I thought so. Go ahead and kill you. And he whirlwinds me out into my Ho-Oh. So now we've just got Mewtwo here. And I'm going to just go ahead and hit a Tailwind and an Extreme Speed onto this Mewtwo. Because it's going to outspeed me and I'm likely its target, so Arceus is, so I'm going to just go ahead and get a nice, huge chunk off this thing. Yeah, and you're just going to go ahead and go down. R.I.P. He goes ahead and hit me with that, at a nice crisp. Alright, so I'm gonna flamethrower you and I'm gonna hit you up with my mixtape. This is pretty much over. Goodbye. Catch all these mixtapes. I didn't burn him. Okay, so he whirlwinds out my grout on it. Like he fell tall. I'm so sorry, friend. So, you're gonna have a bad time. Goodbye. So yeah, that was a fun battle. He literally whirlwinded me out into my Eveltal. That was very unlucky for him. So anyway, I'm gonna search for one more battle and finish talking about Global Link. Unless we get another battle in the time. So, this is nothing new. No new information here. Alright. Raiding battles against trainers around the world. Raiding battles are where the trainers of the world battle with their favorite Pokemon to decide who is the strongest trainer of all. After becoming a member of Pokemon Global Link and registering your Pokemon Sun or Pokemon Moon game, you'll be able to use the website. There will be some changes in the battle formats and methods with the update for Pokemon Sun and Moon. Details below. The battle rules and blah blah blah. We already know about these. And special. These are basically just like the special battles like Johto and Kanto Classic and all that junk. So, on to that. This is the VGC 16 rule set. VGC 2017 rule set. Which I have shared in the group once. I'll read it to you right now anyway. So the main rules here are the double battle format. And send the Pokemon that appear in the Alola region Pokedex. Excluding some legendary and mythical Pokemon such as Solgaleo, Lunala, and Magearna. If Ultra Beasts are playable, I'm pretty sure that those are going to be banned as well. The use of Mega Stones is not allowed, so we did get the confirmation of Mega Evolution, but in VGC 2017, we will not be able to use Mega Evolution. They are completely banning Mega Stones, which is, it's a little bittersweet to me because you are taking out a chunk of the game, but at the same time, we have seen what Mega Kangaskhan has done to the metagame. We have seen what Mega Salamence has done to the metagame. We do not need this again. And, I'm pretty sure they want to focus on everything that's fresh and new. So, it makes perfect sense here. And only Pokemon that can be attained in Pokemon Sun and Pokemon Moon may be entered. And at that time, that should be a no-brainer. But anyway, I'm not sure what this is. My time system for rating battle. A new system being introduced for the battle set, time setting is your time. When using this method of time time accounting, players will have a maximum of 60 seconds each turn to select a move for Pokemon. Okay, so this is the timer stalling thing. If they will also each be awarded 10 minutes of your time. Under these rules, if a player runs out of their 10 minutes before the battle ends, that player loses the match. This will mean matches can be decided more quickly than in the past, allowing players to enjoy thrilling battles. Note, the exclusion of certain legendary mythical Pokemon from single and double battle regulations remain the same as in the past. I don't really understand how this has to do with the timer, but okay. You literally just said that twice up above. Anyway, note, in addition to Pokemon obtainable in Pokemon Sun and Pokemon Moon, Pokemon obtainable in Pokemon X, Pokemon Y, Pokemon Omega Ruby, and Pokemon Alpha Sapphire will also become eligible to use under the regulations of single double rating battles for a set time after the update to Pokemon Bank in January 2017. Well, I'd hope so. Note, at a later date, special rules are anticipated for rating battles and live competitions that will allow the use of Pokemon brought into Pokemon Sun or Pokemon Moon from Nintendo 3DS Virtual Console software titles Pokemon Red, Pokemon Blue, and Pokemon Yellow Special Pikachu Edition. So yeah, that's pretty cool. Anyway, I'm gonna go ahead and whoop this guy's ass, and then I'll talk about what my real favorite thing is about this game. So this man's running some nice triple psychic. He's got Lugia, he's got his Peadon, he's got Deoxys Defense. I've never seen one of these in Ubers before. He's got Mega Mewtwo, he's got his own Arceus, and he's got an Azernius. Okay, so this is a pretty easy Kangaskhan, and probably just an easy Kangaskhan Groudon lead, honestly. I possibly want to lead Kangaskhan Yveltal. I'm going to do that. Yeah, he's got Arceus and Deoxys out, so I'm going to go ahead and Dark Pulse and Fake out here. I'm not really sure what this thing's going to do, but, I mean, I know Yveltal's going to be chunking this thing, so... Let me just go ahead and take this nice chunk out of your ass real quick. The Arceus is going to flinch, so... Yeah, at the most, I imagine he might paralyze me or go ahead and set up a Calm Mind or Cosmic Power, but, I mean, it's not taking two Dark Pulses, so... I'm not too worried about it, honestly. So, we get the Fake out. You flinch. Go ahead and get this Dark Pulse and just immediately freaking die. That was yummy. If he sends out Xerneas or he can just click X, I mean, that's cool too. We take those points. I don't really know how high I am on the ladder right now. I did dip below because I tilted a little bit off screen, but, you know, whatever. We'll search for one more and then we might move a little bit of Little Cup. And maybe I can finish reading through Pokemon Global Link. This is my favorite part of this. Battle with other players Okay, this is one of my favorite parts. Battle with other players Pokemon. In Pokemon Sun and Pokemon Moon, you can register Pokemon that you often use in battle teams, which can contain anywhere from 1 to 6 Pokemon. You can set up a maximum of 6 battle teams, and the same Pokemon can be registered to several battle teams simultaneously. This basically says, we will have 6 battle boxes. This is a godsend. I am tired of having to go back into my freaking battle box and change my stuff around. I really hope that this does not mean that my Hoopa Unbound, my Shaman Sky, and things like that will revert back to Hoopa Confined and, Shaman Landform, because that is the most annoying thing. I hate having to have them in my party only. Like, I understand if they're in the PC box, but if they're in the battle box, they should stay the way they are, honestly. But, you know, that's a rant for another day. When the Pokemon Global Link gets updated for Pokemon Sun and Pokemon Moon, a new feature will be available. QR Rental Teams. Oh, baby. Players will be able to publicly share their own teams, and to use battle teams designed by other players. Public battle teams can be used by scanning in their QR code patterns from the Pokemon Global Link. You can take part in Link battles and certain rating battles using a battle team you've rented. You may even be able to try battling using the Pokemon of expert players, like the victors of the Pokemon World Championships. So I can just go and grab Ever and Zhang's team off freaking Global Link and try it out in rating battles. Like, what the hell, friend? Like, you can go and look at top VGC players' teams. If they've got their teams uploaded to Global Link, you can download their QR code, scan it, and try out their teams for yourself. I mean, they won't be in your game or anything. Like, they'll just be only on Battle Spot. I mean, rating battles and stuff, and Link battles. But, I mean, still, this is awesome. And it looks like, you know, they'll be, they'll kind of look like this, which I'm pretty sure this means basically like you're using a rented team. So obviously the players will know that it's not your team. And you can't take this team, like a rented team, to like official VGC or anything, because that'd just be ridiculous. But I mean, honestly, that's honestly kind of dope. And I'm very excited for that. And it looks like we got a battle. I'm not sure what I'm looking at right now. This looks like some sort of messed up VGC 16 team. We got Clefable, we've got Sableye, we've got Kyogre, we've got Giratina, and we've got Ferrothorn, and we've got Greninja. Alright. So immediately I'm seeing that my Yveltal tears this team a new one. So I'm going to lead Kangaskhan Yveltal. We're going to get Greninja and Ferrothorn. So I'm going to go ahead and just pulse this. While you get faked out, take a massive wallop. Alright, that's a decent amount of damage. I get the nice flinch, that's pretty cool. I will take that, and he forfeits. Lovely. We're just getting all those X buttons tonight. I'm going to read this and then try maybe some doubles OU. We'll wrap this up with some DOU. I'll use that team, yeah. Gold mission in the starting, gold mission, blah, blah, blah. So that's basically just talking about opening for friendly competitions. We knew about that, online competitions, live competitions. We already knew about all that junk. So, I mean, that's nothing new. That's nothing new. So, yeah, that's pretty much all I have to say about that. Got Ash Greninja, the new Pokemon. So, I'm going to show you guys the starter leaks real quick. So if you don't want to see those, I should just come back in, I don't know, give me about 5 minutes, 10 tops. And then you could, you know, join me back for our wrap-up Doubles OU session. And, you know, I don't really need these anymore. So, I'll go ahead and give you guys about, let's say, 15 seconds to click out of this. If you don't want to be spoiled, possibly. Alright, time's up. No more waiting. So we've got Dartrix and Rowlet here. Now, I want you to take a very good look at Dartrix. And now, I'm going to show you another call that's interrupting my video yet again. God damn it. Now, this thing has everyone going crazy. Because, honestly, this thing looks really cool. So, obviously, it's based on an archer because I believe Rowlet just kind of threw its feathers around. Dartrix was based on darts, and now we've basically got the literal Hawkeye in the game. So, looks like his bow tie becomes, you know, looks like, you know, some autumn-colored leaves here. The strings here, I'm not really sure what that would really represent. I mean, it looked kind of like he was wearing, like, a suit vest, but, I mean, looks kind of like he just ditches that for... It looks like some sort of sports coat and some sort of... I'm not really sure what's going on here. This feather kind of makes no sense, but it looks kind of cool. So, basically, he's going to be able to grab these strings, use his own wing and appendage as a freaking bow and arrow, and shoot his own quills at you. Which is honestly awesome. I mean, there's nothing really negative I can say about this. Other than, he looks a little funky without the hood. But, I mean, other than that, I'm really fine with it. And I'm not really sure. I'm guessing that's kind of to represent a sniper scope. So, I mean, like, he fine-tunes his focus on his enemy and shoots the arrows and such. And I'm rambling at this point. But, honestly, I like this thing. I want to raise one very badly. And, yeah. That's Rowlet's final evolution. I'm going to save you for last. I've got a lot to say about you, my friend. So next we've got Popplio and Brionne. Now, obviously people are kind of pissed off that this thing looks so feminine, but honestly, I don't mind. Like, it honestly looks really cute. I personally am not really feeling these design on these two. Like, I'm really just not. Like, Popplio's cool. Popplio's a cool dude. I like Popplio, but I'm just not feeling that design very much. But this woman right here. Like, this beauty right here, though. This right here, it just has all of my yes. Just literally all of my yes. Like, this design is amazing. It fits. It goes along with the whole pop star thing. I believe it's based off of a siren, so I'm not really sure how it goes from circus sea lion to pop star to siren, but I mean, whatever. I mean, I'll always use the Remoraid and Octillery argument when I try to make sense of things. But anyway, it looks like this thing's still going to be singing. It's still going to have something to do with bubbles, I guess. And it still has the clown nose, as we can see. But it looks a lot more like a mermaid than anything than it has for, you know, a sea lion. But, I mean, I don't know. It looks like a cross between a mermaid and your typical siren, even though sirens, I believe, were human-esque. So, I don't know. Well, okay. A little bit of a head spoiler. I'm not really sure what happens with the hair here. It looks like these hairpins are actually bubbles. So that's pretty interesting. And I honestly love this little freaking top here. Like, it's so cute. It's such a cool design. It kind of just looks like it's wearing a skirt or like a... And just like a long skirt here. And I'm obviously curious of how tall this thing is because... I mean, standing up off your belly onto your freaking flippers like this can't be easy. Like, that has to have some sort of muscle. And honestly, if this thing doesn't get pixelate hyper voice and, you know, hydro pump, I'm gonna be very upset. I mean, it's literally singing. Let this thing scream at you. Let this be the good version of Mega Gardevoir and Sylveon. So anyway, that's Popplio. I love it. I want one. Now we get to Litten. Oh boy, Litten. Litten and Torracat. I love them both. I love them to death. But, people are hating on this thing. And you're about to see why very quickly. You know what? Why don't I take a minute and read to you Torracat's description? The bell-like object attached at the base of Torracat's neck is a flame sac, an organ that can produce flames. Torracat's emotions cause a rise in the organ's temperature, and when the organ spits flames, it rings with the high, clear sound of a bell. Torracat attacks using the flames emitted from the bell. Torracat's mane serves as an excellent sensory organ, and it can sense what's going on around it, even in the dark. I don't know how that works, but I guess it's... similar to whiskers, I guess. I don't know. It can also detect the presence of hidden enemies. Well, I'd hope so. Torracat has a great love for battle and will attack so relentlessly that its opponents lose the will to fight. That's my kind of dog right there. And yet, it sometimes will behave like a spoiled child in front of trainers or Pokemon with whom it has built trust or relationship with. So basically, it's an attention whore like me. Like, this Pokemon is literally me, in a nutshell. The cat punch that this Pokemon can dish out with its strong forelegs is extremely powerful. It can bend iron bars and knock out large men with a single blow. I want those last two lines to sit and marinate in your brain for a moment. I'll read them to you one more time. The cat punch that this Pokemon can dish out with its strong forelegs is extremely powerful. It can bend iron bars and knock out large men with a single blow. Alright, so this thing's throwing hands now. Like, okay. So let's go ahead and get to this big bastard. This is Litten's final evolution, people. Big Macho Man. It's said to be fire dark, but honestly, it could go fighting. I mean, look at these freaking pecs right here. Look at these abs. Look at these biceps. Look at these wrestling moves. This man's getting pile-drived right here. I mean, honestly, Look at this champion belt. Stop calling me, for God's sakes. But, anyway. Hopefully this thing isn't fire. Okay, looks like we're good again. Anyway. I'm sorry about that. That call just went straight to my phone and kicked me off of here for a moment. Don't, remind me to scold them a little bit later. But anyway, look at these biceps. Look at these pectorals. This man obviously skipped leg day. He's wearing a freaking championship belt, for crying out loud. And look at that freaking face. This thing is ready to kill somebody. I will say the flame belt is a pretty nice touch. I'm really feeling that. But, I mean, I'm okay with this because I love cats. I love big cats to death. And I really love wrestlers. I love wrestling. I mean, not like the fake crap, but I mean like legitimate wrestling. Like, I've always been a fan of wrestling. So, I mean, this thing's pretty cool in my opinion. And plus, I love MMA, and this thing's apparently throwing punches out here, so that's pretty cool. We've got Ash, Mallow, Poplio, and Rowlet freaking heating up some tea on Final Evolution Litten's belt. That is honestly hilarious. I cannot wait for this scene in the anime. But yeah, like I'm saying, Fire Dark is some pretty nice coverage. If we get some fighting coverage along with that, like, you know, knockoff, flare blitz, close combat, superpower, something like that, that'd honestly be pretty neat. And I mean, firefighting is one of the best, you know, it's one of the better type combinations. I mean, fire and fighting coverage hits so much. I mean, I know we've had it a few times, but honestly, who cares? Like, I honestly don't care. Like, it's a solid typing. You got a lot of coverage. I mean, you're not that great defensively, but I mean, offensively, that is a nightmare of a typing. You see what Blaziken's doing out here to people. You see what Infernape's doing to people in UU, and sometimes in OU. You see what Embor is doing to people down there in RU. I don't want to imagine what this thing's going to be doing to me if this thing is bending iron bars in its second state. This thing hasn't even evolved yet. People. I mean, honestly, like, I know people are complaining about this, but I mean, honestly, shut up. Like, I mean, I know if we get another firefighting type, that'll be a little bland. But I mean, honestly, this thing looks cool as hell, in my opinion. But overall, we've got a new Pokemon to play with. We've got new stuff. We've got new starters. We've got a brand new adventure. If you don't like it, pick one of the other two. But honestly, everyone's tired of hearing your crap. Rant over. So anyway, we don't need that anymore. So anyway, I'm definitely still going Team Litten, but I am going to be importing myself a Rowlet and a Poplio. Poplio's Final Evolution is easily my second favorite out of the bunch. Rowlet, I'm still feeling you, but not quite as much. I'm sorry. Anyway, let's go ahead and just grab us a nice doubles OU battle and wrap this thing up. And we've got Attack Deoxys, an Aerodactyl, a Jolteon, Darkrai, Weavile, and Alakazam. So immediately I'm thinking I can just go ahead and lead off with my Politoed and my Kingdra and just murder everything. So I'm going to go ahead and drop a nice Scald on this Weavile and protect my Kingdra. Since I'm almost positive he's going to go and drop a Fake Out on my Kingdra here. Because Kingdra's the obvious threat. So I'm going to go ahead and just break this Weavile sash. And then I'm going to go ahead and hit him with a Helping Hand Muddy Water to finish it off. I'm not really sure what the Darkrai wants to do here. But I guess he could hit me with a Life Orb Dark Pulse. Or if he's real, he might try to hit me with an Icy Wind to slow me down. But let's see. Yeah, predicted that. He goes for the Snarl. That's fine. I didn't actually know Darkrai got Snarl. So, we're gonna go ahead and click Helping Hand. Help Masamune out and hit this Muddy Water. And hopefully I can take out this Darkrai. If not, that's okay. Because his whole team is honestly pretty frail. Like, other than maybe the Jolteon, I can knock everything out in one shot. I'll have to lean on my Politoed a little bit to get through this Deoxys and possibly this Alakazam. Okay, these two both die, so I'm not going to get Snarl today. The power of freaking Kingdra. The power of rain. The power of not having any rain counters. So, I'm going to go ahead and hit another Helping Hand, and I imagine the Jolteon. He might be triple, he might be triple, sashed. We'll find out in a moment. Okay, I missed this. That's fine. He goes Dazzling Gleam. That's fine. If he goes Deoxys, we'll have a bit of an issue. But honestly, I kind of want him to so I can go ahead and break both of their sashes. Okay, so you can actually go ahead and E-Speed me here, which is going to be a problem. So instead of hitting Helping Hand, I'm just going to go ahead and Scald this Deoxys and hit Muddy Water. And if my Kingdra dies, I'll just let it die. I missed the Alakazam again. That is honestly okay. He goes ahead and kills both of these Pokemon. That's fine. So I'm going to go ahead and send out my Mawile and my Breloom. And I'm going to just go ahead and hit him with an Iron Head and a Mach Punch. Unless he doubles on my Breloom, it's not going to die, since I am Focus Sashed. And this Iron Head is going to hit this Alakazam, for sure. And there's nothing that Aerodactyl is going to be doing that can beat me. So, I mean, I still have Kyurem in the back, I still have my own Thunderous in the back. And I do have the T-Wave on my Thunderous, so I can slow down that Aerodactyl to the point where my Kyurem can just knock him out safely. So, yeah, this battle's pretty much a wrap already. So, I mean, I'm going to go ahead and drop that early GG on him. He does not have the E-Speed. He goes ahead and hit me with that Psychic. That's fine. Go ahead and hit you with that hit you down to your Sash. So, he was running Double Sash. So, I'm going to go ahead and hit this Aerodactyl up with an Iron Head and go ahead and Mach Punch this Alakazam. Hit him with that GG. And that's going to wrap up this game. That is going to be a fine 3-0 ass clap. And, erp. Goodbye, friend. Goodbye. So, I mean, that was a decent battle. I had fun with it. Wasn't the best battle I've had, but oh well. I do still love this team. But anyway, that's pretty much all I have today. I might do another live later on, you know, after I, you know, eat and everybody gets settled in and all that junk, since I don't have too much of a busy day tomorrow, so I might stay up a little later. And, oh yeah, Mr. Turdinator, please be awesome. I have high hopes for you. But anyway, I'm gonna go ahead and get up out of here. I'll see you guys in the group a little later.